entirely from the different background. So let me first introduce our institute is Indian Rubber Manufacturers Research Association. Then similar institute like CBPRI working under Department of DPIT, Ministry of Industry and Commercial Industry, Government of India. So we are working for rubber industry. Similarly for paper industry, we are working for rubber industry. And the service areas we cater to the rubber industry in terms of testing, certification, research and product development and industrial consultancy. Coming to this topic, you might wonder why all most of the rubber products are black in color. We see tire or other, most of the rubber products are black in color because of the most commonly used filler to improve the properties, specifically the physical properties of rubber products is carbon black. Carbon black which is derived from again what we are talking from morning fossil fuel, petroleum derived carbon blacks. So in order to reduce the consumption of carbon black, you know the tire industry is huge and the consumption of carbon black is also huge. So we are talking since morning energy conservation, sustainability, circular economy. So in this we have focused how we can utilize lignin as a filler or which can fully replace or partially also if it can replace the carbon black, it can serve the purpose. So even the 5 or 10% replacement of carbon black in tire industry will be huge. So keeping that in mind, we have focused and we have chosen the tire grade formulation particularly. So this is a typical formulation for rubber compounds. Something new for you people, but we have rubber, then we have fillers, then other additives like some curing agents, some antioxidants, antiozonants, some plasticizers are there. But the majority is fillers. Like we have different carbon blacks, like in high abrasive furnace black. So there are several types of carbon blacks depending on the particle size and surface area. We have categorization or classification of carbon blacks. So in this case, we have taken 3 types of lignin and we have tried to replace with 5 PHR and 10 PHR. These are some results. So I will be discussing only findings, what we have found. I will not go in detailed discussion of results. So curing characteristics is, we can relate these properties with the productivity of rubber industry. When curing means the molding of rubber products into different shapes and sizes. So if the curing time increases, the productivity of the industry will decrease and obviously the productivity is linked with the profit. So profit will go down. So what we have found, because of the acidic nature of this lignin, because of the presence of some phenolic carboxylic groups on the surface of lignin, the curing characteristics or curing time of rubber is increasing. So this found to be deteriorating the curing time and may increase the productivity. So that is one of the drawback of this lignin. And also from the physico-mechanical properties, it is found that the mechanical properties are also going down. So what we have tried it with the highly reinforcing carbon black. So observation or the findings from this study, I can say from the as such we have used lignin, we have not modified anything whatever we have received from CBPRI. Without any modification we have used and we have found that it is also increasing the productivity, means reducing the productivity by increasing curing time, and also the mechanical properties are not so improving. So in order to overcome this problem, what we thought, so we can modify the sample. So the coupling agents are being used in rubbers to improve the compatibility between filler and rubber matrix. So we have used coupling agent. Modified lignin. Again, we have taken the same SBR, BR, butadiene tire formulation, and we have modified lignin powder with the help of silane coupling agent. What we have found out, after modification, the particle size of lignin, because of the high surface energy of lignin particles because of the hydrogen groups and phenolic groups, there is a strong interparticle interactions. But after modification, the interparticle interaction reduced and the particle size also, we can see, got decreased. So with the help of this, we have prepared again samples at 5 and 10 pHr with unmodified, modified, and also one of the advantages of using lignin because of the phenolic OH groups present on the lignin, it can act as an antioxidant or antiozonant as well in the rubber products. So we have already patented one patent that is studied on with nitrile rubber, but we are I am presenting here with the styrene butadiene and natural rubber one, that is general purpose rubber. So not only as a filler, but lignin can be used as an antioxidant or as an antiozonant as well, and sometimes it can act as a plasticizer to reduce the viscosity of rubber compounds, wherein many plasticizing agents like petroleum oil, like aromatic paraffinic or naphthenic based oils are being used as a plasticizer. So not only as a filler, but lignin could be an multifunctional additives for rubber industry. So that what we have found out from this study. So I will not go again in detail because already the time is up. So I just would like to conclude from the studies. What I would like to summarize, that alone lignin without any modification, if you are using, it is decreasing the productivity. Also the mechanical properties are deteriorating. So in order to overcome that problems, we have modified the lignin, and what we have found out, the use of coupling agent improves the mechanical properties, but the loading of lignin was limited up to 5 to 10 pHr because of its high polarity. But as such, lignin being a polar, it can go with the polar rubbers like nitrile rubber or chloroquine rubber. But if you have to use with general purpose rubber like natural rubber, styrene butadiene rubber or butadiene rubber, you need to modify. So further what we have tried, we can carbonize the lignin. After carbonization, the particle size will go down and the reinforcing efficiency of lignin will improve, and the filler loading from 5 pHr, it was improved to 50 pHr. So consumption of lignin with rubber also will improve. So carbonization can help, and not as a highly reinforcing carbon black, but we can replace it with the non-reinforcing carbon black grades. So that what I look as an opportunity for paper industry with rubber industry. So we can have some interdisciplinary research with rubber, and we will try to utilize the lignin as a waste from paper industry to the value added filler to the rubber industry. Thank you.